Welcome to Foundations TV. We are here on location for International Yoga Day, which has been declared as the first International Yoga Day by the United Nations. And Boston and all the organizations in and around Boston have taken the greatest initiative to come together and put together a wonderful four-hour event here to celebrate the International Yoga Day. And we have with us Suresh Ji, who has headed this team, and he obviously gives the entire credit to the entire team who has worked very hard to put this event together. So Suresh, welcome to Foundations TV.
Thank you very much, Gauriji. And I also want to reiterate, I'm one of the people who helped organizing this event. I had such a wonderful group of people who worked day in and day out, and they credited with me leading the team. Actually, that's not the case. And we have volunteers from 22 organizations who really worked unabatedly planning every single thing about the event.
Wonderful. So I do want to know, how did this idea or inspiration come to your mind to get all these organizations together for the first time to create an event such as this?
That's a very good question. And we were very excited when United Nations declared June 21st as International Day of Yoga. We live in a world that is mired with conflict, greed, and all kind of individualism. We have been thinking for some time, what can we do to make a difference in people's life and take the message of yoga? We were happy that we had an occasion, June 21st, bring community together and celebrate this unique wisdom, though which was originated in India, practiced in India, but over a period of time, people have contributed to spread the message of yoga, and we wanted to become part of it. And that was the main inspiration to start the program. And then we reached out to all the local yoga loving organizations to join hand and design the program.
So, wonderful. And did you face any challenges while you were doing this?
Gauriji, I was very fortunate, and I must say there was tremendous enthusiasm, energy, dynamism, imagination, passion. Everybody was driven by a single motive and single objective. What can we do to make a difference in people's life? Yoga, in this world where we have controlled communicable diseases, we are getting this phenomenal rise of non-communicable diseases, that is lifestyle diseases. The anxiety, the tension, the pressure of our job, our lifestyle. I mean, world is becoming a global capital of diabetes, stress. And we thought that, you know, yoga is such a nice practice in our daily life, which generates harmony between mind, body, environment. Can we reduce some of those lifestyle diseases? And because everybody was working with that motive, so really we did not encounter any challenge in organizing this event. I mean, it's a very joyful experience.
That is, I can sense the passion in everybody who is present here today. That is really a beautiful, beautiful thing. So what are your aspirations for our community as we move forward?
Absolutely. See, when we thought about celebrating this program, it came to our mind what we want to achieve out of this activity. Is it a one-day event? Do the hoopla, celebrate, bring people together, have good time, and go. And clearly that was not the thought process. We thought that there is scientific evidence that yoga is very beneficial in many non-communicable diseases, specifically obesity, diabetes, and stress, anxiety, etc., etc. And that is one aspect. Second aspect is yoga has become a lifestyle, particularly in Western world and in America. But dichotomy or unfortunate part is simultaneously yoga has become something which is available to people who have resources. Yoga has become a fad for the people who are a little more figure conscious. But The reality of the life is we have communities around us who have this problem of diabetes, obesity, stress. For example, our veterans from the military. For example, underemployed youth and unemployed youth, they go through tremendous stress. For example, Latino Americans, for African Americans, where diabetes and obesity is a real problem. So our goal was, out of this event, can we create community awareness? Number one. Number two, can we identify one or two communities where on a continuous basis we can provide free yoga classes to make a difference? So that's what our aspiration is.
Excellent. And we wish you all the best for
that. Thank you very much. And thank you very much for the support of the program. We are really thankful to Foundation TV. You guys have done an excellent job in spreading the message and coming over here. Thank you, Gauriji.
Most welcome.
Wonderful.
The meaning of our next sloka is Om. I make reverential obeisance to Patanjali, the illustrious of sages who best have quietness of mind through yoga.
Last 15 months, 177 countries have ratified it, and in over 200 countries, this event is celebrated today.
Meditation sessions, stress management workshops, substance free mind and body dance parties, and other community service events. We would also like to thank NIT Sanskrita. It's a group for Sanskrit speaking and learning enthusiasts. Sanskrit, many of you know, is a rich ancient language with a treasure trove of literature. Including several fundamental works of yoga, volunteers lead interactive classes for both beginners and more advanced students.
And as well, MIT Kindle Students Council is a student group for Kindle activities at MIT.
As exclusive reports from local events. Foundations TV has a strong following both online and on social media. So welcome them, and we'd also like to welcome the next people on stage today. You're actually going to be seeing some martial arts, but with some yoga. So very, very interesting event that we're putting together next, and you're going to be seeing it in a moment. So welcome them. The Malakam.
Continues to be attacked from north and western sides. So there was a big war about to happen. So they put up a condition saying, no bloodshed. Let's try to solve it in a peaceful manner. So they said, let's play a wrestling match. I'm gonna go get some more.
Welcome to Foundations TV, everybody. We are here with Mr. Jay Gupta, who is the founder of RX Relax, and he and his wife have dedicated their lives to yoga. And obviously, we wanted to hear him talk about the International Yoga Day, where over 20 organizations have come together in and around Boston to create a unique and historic event. So how are you feeling about this event, Jay?
I am very excited about it. It's the first International Yoga Day, and to be part of it, it's really honoring, and to see these many organizations coming together is also very, very exciting.
Now, I do believe you are leading two sessions here today, so can you talk a little bit about what you're going to be doing in those sessions?
Well, to start this day, we'll do some yogic suksham vyayam. We call it subtle yoga for rejuvenation, so just loosening up the body parts, the muscles and the joints, and then we'll lead people into, you know, other sessions. Mostly it'll be performances or meditations and talks. And the second session we have is more therapeutic session, in which my understanding is the stress causes most of the disease conditions. So how do we manage it better? So it will be a relaxing, meditative session, so people can feel some benefit of that.
Wonderful. And how many people do you think we're expecting today?
Well, we have about 800 people registered. I think it was two nights back, it was 798. So I will see because of the weather also, but I'm just very excited to see at 6 o'clock we had almost 100 people here, which I didn't expect like so early in the morning.
Wonderful. All the best for the event, and we look forward to your sessions.
Great. Thank you so much. I have one more thing to say. Absolutely. Although we are celebrating this International Day of Yoga, but yoga is supposed to be done every day. So as a pharmacist, I believe yoga is a medicine. And the effect can last more than 24 hours, but it's good to repeat your medicine every 24 hours. So if you do yoga, please do it every day. If you don't do yoga, do it twice a day.
Wonderful message indeed. Thank you.
Thank you, Gauri.
And see how it feels. And if it feels okay, let's make a little bigger circle and slow it down. And let's make the breath. Inhaling, going up. Exhaling, coming down. You're moving all the intercostal muscles, so take full advantage. If you're not able to see me, we have Ruth here, we have Miru Ben, we have Sudhir Bhai, we have Ted here, and everybody. So make sure you're doing it right. So stopping for a moment, and let's reverse the direction. Deep breath. Sitting, we'll do a side bend. Inhaling up, exhaling the chin side. Inhale, exhale at your own pace.
That brings a lot of relaxation while you are acting, while you are doing something. It brings relaxation. So deeper, slower breathing, conscious, deeper, slower breathing. The third item is be happy, like if you remember, smile, so be happy. So the third item, which is called prasanna. Then, after that, fourth one is focused mind. What we are doing, whenever we are talking at it, then focus on mind upon the eyebrows. And then, if you're sitting for meditation, you meditate at home for say minimum 20-22 minutes. We heard from other lady that if you 20 minutes of meditation, it will give you 4 hours of sleep benefit. Good. Let's bring the hands up.
Are you ready?
Take a deep breath in and then sit like a chair. And take deep breaths here. Do not hold the breath.
Lama Sasri.
Everybody sucha.
Stretch your arms up above your head while keeping your palms pressed together. Lean backwards and squeeze your stomach in and keep your legs together. Your arms should be pressed tightly to your ears, and this has many benefits for your back and your abdomen. So, position two. Lean forward and try to touch your toes. Your legs should still be straight. The ideal position is pressing your forehead to your knees while keeping your legs straight. This position has many benefits for flexibility. Arch your back and look up at the ceiling. This provides a good stretch for your hips and your back. Position four, bring your right leg back. Make your body into a flat plane. Your hips should be in the same angle as your shoulders and ankles. Look 4 feet in front of you. Position five, touch your knees, chest, and forehead to the ground. Position six, come up out of the previous pose into Bhujangasana, the cobra pose. Keep your legs on the ground and pick up your chest, stretching your back and abdominal muscles. Look at the ceiling. Position seven. This pose is the mountain pose. Lift your hips up and try to keep your feet flat on the ground. You should be in an inverted V position with straight legs and arms. Align your head with your arms. Position eight. Bring your left leg forward and put your left foot between your hands. Arch your back and push your hips down. Look up, like in position three. And position nine, which is the same as position two. Join your right leg to your left leg and try to touch your toes while keeping your legs straight. And finally, position 10. Stand up straight, look forward with your palms pressed together on your chest. So this is the first set.
Yes, but I need you to put your 100%. When you are 100% in something, your mind is there, and we become as a child. We have childs here. And so I want everyone in the back also.
Yeah. Mr. Benson has always strived for serving the community and to the people of America. He is the first Latino to hold this important position. He is a senior attorney and with a law and a very reputed law firm for many years. He has brought the diversity with his new role by carrying out various initiatives under his leadership. He has always pushed for creation of a homegrown workforce for this surging innovation economy. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm sure you will agree that we all are privileged to have with us Mr. Dennis Benson. Please welcome.
Thank you, Robert, for those very kind words. Namaste, good morning. Happy Father's Day. It's also a very important day for our community in Cambridge. I grew up just behind MIT. I've been here my entire life. My mother came from Puerto Rico, my father from the Dominican Republic. And I can tell you that I didn't really learn about yoga until about 10 years ago. And you know that the practice of yoga has grown when you travel to Puerto Rico and the Dominican Republic and you see people walking down the street with yoga mats. So, and that really is due to all the great work that the folks in the country of India and those of you that are here have done to really expand the practice of yoga throughout the country. I believe that the practice of yoga is not is really important at this time in our society's history. There's a lot of conflict in the world, and there's a lot going on all over, and we've seen that in South Carolina recently, and we're seeing it around the country and around the world. And I believe that yoga can help us in so many ways. It can help us spiritually, it can help us get in better health and fitness. And it's really going to be up to you guys to go out into the community and make sure that yoga becomes accessible to those in our community that are not privileged enough and cannot afford it. And so before I read a proclamation, I just want to say this, and I'm probably saying something I probably shouldn't say, but I want you guys to shut down Mass Ave at some point in time in the next year or even this summer and practice yoga with the community and come in front of City Hall. And you know, make sure that the practice of yoga is getting into our schools, our community centers, our parks, our prisons, because it has so many, many benefits for our community. Working with you in the future. So on behalf of the mayor of Cambridge, who was unable to make it with us today, and on behalf of the city administration and our city council, I am going to read this proclamation. In recognition of International Yoga Day, June 21st, 2015, whereas yoga is an ancient process of keeping the human mind and body in good health. Spiritual training is considered a part of physical training from ancient times in India. Regular practice of yoga postures provide the key health benefits. And whereas First International Yoga Day Celebration Organizing Committee is a group of voluntary, nonprofit, social, and cultural organizations which aims at preserving and passing on the ancient Hindu heritage and cultural values to the next generation of Hindus and raise awareness around the world. And whereas over 170 member states of the United Nations, including the United States and India, collectively declared June 21st as International Yoga Day and are encouraging to practice yoga on that day. And whereas the First International Yoga Day Celebration Organizing Committee is organizing International Yoga Day to promote friendship, mutual understanding, and good health among multicultural and diverse members of the community. And whereas yoga enthusiasts, yoga studios, local schools, and organizations are participating in the International Yoga Day, yoga can be practiced daily as a part of physical activity and...
Welcome everybody, we are here with none other than Ranjani Sehgal. She is here at the International Yoga Day, which is a phenomenal event, a historic event, put together by over 20 organizations in and around Boston. And Ranjani Sehgal, of course, being one of the community leaders, she is here representing multiple organizations and herself. So what do you think about today?
It's really, really exciting to be here today. Yoga means unity. And I think it's just so special that this unity is being defined, not just by the integration of mind, thought, and all of that as they say, but also for organizations to come together, to be together. And I think that is just so special. We are representing different kinds of yogas, and they are all coming together in one place. People, movements, all join together. So it's very exciting to be here.
Wonderful. Now, I heard something about yoga dance, and I believe you were leading that. So tell us something about that, because that sounds so exciting.
Well, being a trained classical dancer, it is obvious that for me, yoga comes through my training in classical dance. Yoga just means there's a lot of energy outside, and yoga allows you to channel that energy within you and express it in a way that can impact the world. For dancers, we use the technique of natya, which is including the use of syllables and the chanting of syllables, just like we would say, it needs breath control to be able to do that. Use that rhythm in our body and then express it. The difference between, I think, or interesting thing about natya is we just don't use the gross movements, which is often shown in yoga, but we use our fingers. We have to stretch our fingers, our eyes, and most importantly, we also do the yoga of emotions. That is, we channel our emotions and express it in a way that makes sense. So, very excited to share Natya Yoga with all of you.
Wonderful, wonderful. Thank you so much.
I have to thank Mother Earth, because no mother allows me to stamp on her head, but Mother Earth allows me to do that. Bhumi, I thank you. And then I pray that all the energies of the universe drawn come into my third eye, so I am inspired so that my inner self can express itself. Natya Yoga. Yoga means channeling of your energies and expressing it in a way that will make positive impact in the universe. And Natya Yoga does it in many different ways. You have seen a lot of control of breath, you've seen body movements, but we do more than that. We use our fingers, our eyes, our emotions, every aspect of our body. Are you ready? You can say, I'm sure, a lot more than I can, and that is wonderful. And when you do this, what happens? You can get something called jati. So look at it. And let me do one example for you. You can join me if you would like. We often start with talang kutakati kutakata dinginato, which means she is doing it like this, we will do it like this. Make sure your fingers are stretched. I don't want that. You're not putting your hand up. Very good.
Wait, I might just start moving.
do this. Lot of dance for the man. Please, put your hands together. Follow along. Thank you, sir. Abhaya ji, not inspiring. Please, not Abhaya. You all can stand. Some of you can stand up. How about you want to stand up and hold it?
Received both traditional and contemporary education in India. He graduated from Tibetan Institute of Sanskrit University in Varanasi. Lamar served as the head of Sakya Center in Rajpur, India, and the Sakya Monastery in Puravalla, India. Lama Mi'kmaq has supervised the editing and publication of more than 50 rare volumes of Sakya literature and is author of many books, including Awakening to the Noble Truth, Tibetan Book of Awakening, The Play of Mahamudra, and many more. He is the founder of Sakya Institute for Buddhist Studies in Cambridge, Massachusetts. Lama Mi'kmaq leads retreats throughout North America and Europe. Today,
but we all are from Himalaya.
Yeah.
So I will quiz you. Where do the Lord Shiva live?
Kailash.
Where is Kailash?
Himalaya.
Tibet. So you should say, and you should think, that the first yogi who practiced yoga in Kailash. Do you agree?
Yes.
So Kailash is so important. Important for all the Hindus. Important for all the Buddhists. Important for shamanic bones. Important for many, many other spiritual disciplines. Why it is important? Because it is divine. It is the place from where yoga is started. So today, we are celebrating UN Yoga Day. So, last, I want to share you one mantra. This mantra is called Mantra of Compassion. And you repeat after me this mantra, and if you can recite this mantra can fill your heart with love and compassion. So, repeat after me. Om Mani Padme Hum. Om Mani Padme Hum. Om Mani Padme Hum.
Yogis think, and yoga comes from a Greek word called yuj, which means connection, communication, union. When I connect with the self, with the soul, with the self-realization, and give a flow of positive thoughts to the mind. Because today's world, there are a number of base thoughts and negative thoughts. But Rajiv,
for doing the sankalp, I would like all of you to raise your right hand with me. And you, if you would be kind enough to repeat after me, I would like to commit to make myself into a healthy, peaceful, joyful, loving and caring human being. I commit myself through every action of mine, I will strive to create a peaceful and loving atmosphere around me. I strive to take every action of mine with a smile. I will strive to break the limitations of who I am right now and include the entire world as my own. I recognize the kinship of my own life with every other life around me. I recognize the unity of all there is. Thank you and happy Yoga Day to all of you.
Thank you.
To bring this program today, we are here to celebrate International Day of Yoga. We are not only celebrating the Yoga Day, but we are celebrating and enjoying the biggest contribution of India and Hinduism to the world. That does not mean that we own this greatest wisdom. People across the world, hundreds and thousands, they have contributed, practiced, preserved, perfected, and given all the best component of the yoga to all of us. We are grateful. To make this event successful today, I'm really indebted and thankful to our team at MIT, that is Jay Chandra Ji, who is a student here, a graduate student, and represents Sanskrit Bharati. In addition to Jay Chandra Ji, we have Deepak Subramani Ji, who represents Hindu Student Council, and Kishore Ji, who is representative of Art of Living. Without these three individuals, this program would not have been possible. And we are also thankful to MIT for letting us host the program. Last but not the least, we have a team of around 30 volunteers who work for more than 12 weeks every week in teleconferences, making the arrangements, scheduling the program, printing, sending emails, raising money, etc., etc. And why we are doing it? We are not doing it to have a fun for one day. These volunteers, they are committed, they are passionate to make a difference in people's lives. They want to take to the yoga to the communities where they need it. The people who cannot afford yoga, they really want to take yoga where the communities are suffering with the non-communicable diseases such as lifestyle diseases, obesity.